Hey everybody, what's going on? Hellmite here, bringing you another video from Grab the Lantern. Today is Tuesday and the patch notes have been posted, which means it's time for another top 5 changes in patch 11.12. As per usual, I'll be going through the biggest or most impactful changes in this week's patch and letting you guys know what you can be looking forward to in the coming weeks. 11.12 is a bit on the small side as Riot have bundled a bunch of systemic changes into the next patch cycle. You guys can see more about that. That's all the systemic mobility reduction that Riot are doing that I made a video on yesterday if you're interested, but either way, 11.12 still has enough changes for us to talk about, including a couple of spicy ones here. So let's go ahead and get started with the number 5 change here, which is the Dr. Mundo rework is coming to live on this week's patch. Super excited for this one. I feel like he's going to be really fun to play, especially his passive. I think is incredibly strong and gives Dr. Mundo the ability to really do some crazy things in teamfights, especially if he's able to pick up that canister constantly. So the biggest thing is he's just a champion that has the ability to fail, but he also has the ability to win big if he's able to play his cards right. So super excited to see how this rework shapes out, and I'll definitely be playing him in the coming weeks and letting you guys know what you can be looking forward to expect on this champion. Moving on to the number 4 change here, it's Aphelios. Now, Aphelios has a couple of sort of interesting changes here. I believe there is an undocumented change that Riot have not actually added to the patch notes, but which is going to be coming, which is a reduction in the amount of damage his Crescendum Chakrams deal. But generally, this is supposed to be a buff to Aphelios, generally making him feel a little bit better. And because of this, Riot are essentially moving power out of his better weapons. In this case, it's mostly Severum and Crescendum in order to try and make some of his other combinations feel a little bit better. Chief among them, Infernum and Gravitum, as those are the two that it just feels like don't feel very good, especially when you get them alongside Severum and Crescendum. It sort of feels like this is total non-bow, and Riot are trying to buff that up a little bit. So, in some regards, Aphelios is getting some smaller nerfs to these weapons, but the buffs he's getting in exchange are pretty spicy and should make things like Severum and Infernum actually feel usable, whereas right now it just kind of feels like, why bother? On top of those changes, he also has a couple of base stat increases just to make him feel a little bit better. One of this is just a rounding change, but the 30 magic resist at level 1 is actually pretty nice. It does mean he's a little bit more durable against some things like cheese mage bot lanes or even champions like Yumi who are going to do a lot of magic damage. The biggest thing here is that generally the Severum base effects are a little bit worse. The number of attack scales worse with attack speed, and the on-hit damage is the healing from basic attacks is down, but the on-hit damage and the healing from abilities is up, which means that while Aphelios is blasting whole teams with Infernum in the middle of an onslaught, he's going to be doing a ton of damage. Crescendum as well, the sentry damage has gone up, so Aphelios in general, I think, should be feeling a lot better about those particular combos of weapons. This isn't a tremendous buff by any stretch of the imagination, but it does make Aphelios feel generally better to play in a lot more scenarios, so that's pretty nice. Moving on down to the number 3 change here, which is the Wukong nerfs. Now, Wukong, I feel like, has been in a very good place for a very long time, and the Divine Sunder buffs didn't do us any favors in that regard. And really, I feel like Wukong, any champion that can not only 1v1 Darius, but also beat the Darius, I think is very, very strong, and Wukong is definitely in that situation. And so he's kind of popped over the top thanks to the Sunder changes. So, right, I've nerfed him down just a little bit here. 5% off the damage ratio and Crushing Blow isn't a huge deal, but the base, the attack damage growth here as well will limit his ability to just kind of one-shot you from stealth by dashing and then queuing you with a Divine Sunder proc on top of that. It's not a huge change, but it's enough that hopefully he's not one-shotting you, and if he can't do that, then ideally it gives you the ability to either run away from him or fight him from that point on. So we'll see how it shakes out, but I do have a little bit of hope for this change here. Moving on to the number 3 change here, which is the Ziggs buffs here. Actually, there's a number 2 change, my apologies. But Ziggs, actually, this buff is really, really spicy for this champion. I feel like he's not been in a great spot for very long, but everything Riot have buffed here is super usable about Ziggs. The base damage went up by 20 on a max range bouncing bomb, which, because you're maxing this first, this is going to be doing a ton of damage in the mid game, and it already hit like a truck in the mid game if you had even a little bit of AP on this champion. So the fact that it's gone up even more and is a fairly spammable ability means that Ziggs will really be able to lay down some DPS in the middle of a fight, or if he is able to fish for poke and land it, he's going to do a ton of damage on top of that. The biggest change here, though, is the Mega Inferno Bomb missile speed, where now it has a 2250 travel time as opposed to 1550. This is almost a doubling in the speed on Mega Inferno Bomb, which means that if Ziggs wants to affect a side lane play beforehand, it took way too long for the bomb to actually travel to the location, and it would either not get there in time to make a difference, or not get there in time for the play at all, and just kind of slam into the lane somewhere far back behind the play before, you know, after the play's already resolved. So this should allow a mid lane Ziggs to really influence the side lanes because of how much quicker this is going to travel. There is a minimum travel time, so obviously he can't just kind of throw it point blank and it's going to travel that much faster, but it's a super big usability change for Ziggs, and it really accentuates what he wants to do, which is sort of be in one lane wave clearing while having the side lane threat of a Mega Inferno Bomb coming down. So really excited to see how these changes shake out for Ziggs, and I think he's going to feel a lot better to play. Finally, moving on to the number one change here, which is the Hecarim changes here. I know Riot keep buffing him up, but I legitimately think these changes are going to be what pushes Hecarim over the top. I've already been saying for a couple of weeks that AD Hecarim builds are going to feel really good. The Sunderer buffs obviously help that further, and on top of that, Riot are giving him some of the base armor back that they took away back when they initially nerfed his tank build, but on top of that, they're buffing up the AD ratio on Rampage yet again to 85% bonus AD. This means that Hecarim will be able to deal a ton of damage. If you recall, there were also a bunch of other sort of spicy AD changes that they made to a bunch of the other fighter items in preparation for the mobility rework, which Hecarim doesn't care about the mobility, right? He's a horse. He runs super fast as is. So I really feel like, especially with the Rampage change here, because it's so spammable, he's able to get a ton of damage off throughout the course of a fight. Like, AD Hecarim, no joke, is going to be pretty good. I do feel like he's not going to be nearly as durable as you might be used to with, like, the Chem Tank Hecarim build, but definitely I think that over the last couple of patch changes, he's gotten into a good spot. So I would definitely be looking to see more Hecarims show up in your games. And that is going to be it for me today, guys. Those are the most important changes in patch 11.12, but let me know what you guys think are some of your most important changes down in this patch as well. I did think the Alawi buff here was pretty spicy, obviously not in the top 5, but because of just how niche Alawi is, but I still really liked the direction that they were taking, so that's probably my pick, but let me know what you guys are thinking down in the comment section below. If you enjoyed the video today, go ahead and leave a like, and if you really enjoyed the video, consider subscribing. I upload a video every Monday, Friday, and on patch days like today as well. Once again, thank you guys so very much for watching. I do appreciate it, and I'll talk to you all later.